I would imagine Chris would be going Nesphere in this matchup. Infinite, if I'm not mistaken, plays Game Watch, if I remember correctly. A very interesting matchup indeed. Both projectile and sword good characters. But Crisp is also able to play, like I said, multiple different characters, so we will see what he decides to bring out today. For a little while. It will be Lance commentating for a little while, so I will be back later.
Right. I am back from my set. 1-2-0, let's go, guys. We get those dubs. Right. Up on stream, we got Frylord Krispy versus Infinite. I actually know a little bit about both these players. Frylord Krispy. Frylord Krispy, a regular at Evo Smash Night, is coming around every Tuesday and Saturday. Watch. He plays a variety of characters. He's played Game and Watch. I've seen him play Pig. And now he's coming out with the NES. Infinite. This is Infinite Llama. I just saw him for the first time last bracket Tuesday. And he came out swinging. I played him round one, and he was actually pretty good. He's very patient Game and Watch. He knows what he's doing. He hits those 1-2 confirms. It's a really, really hard to approach. This matchup, of course, is very heavily in Game & Watch's favor. Actually just box out Master's options, bucket just destroys his hit. But that does not mean it is guaranteed to go into the Game & Watch's favor. We see Krispy coming out with a lot of damage. 70-50%. That up the outer shield is something you're going to be seeing a lot of. Someone touches Game & Watch shields, and you can click up people. It's the fastest outer shield option in the game. You can just click it. It covers everywhere, forward, behind, in front, anywhere you want to do. That Game & Watch up B does everything for you. And just look at this. The ledge pressure that Infinite is bringing out against Krispy, making it really difficult for him to get off the stage. But Krispy, finding his way to the center stage, first trying to get that grab. Ness back throw will kill at this percent, so he has to play it a little bit carefully, but Infinite taking the first stock in game one. Seconds. Infinite just takes the second stock. Absolutely burning through the stocks here. Getting that. I love that bucket. Did you see that? He caught the PK fire with the bucket off stage. Just neutralizing that attack and bringing it to himself. Obviously, if Game & Watch gets that bucket to full, it can be a one-shot KO at like any person. It is a scary move, guys. And, yep, these little. Just 1-2 hit combos that Game & Watch does. Can Krispy make it back? He does. He has those angles. Good to see Krispy around. Playing a little footsies. And now, you see how Infinite has the lead, and he's just staying in this corner, dropping those forward air bombs, and is just sitting around. He can let Krispy play to his hand. He doesn't have to approach. He's winning. If this game goes 4 minutes longer, he wins. And that might be the stock right there. Infinite with a very convincing game one.
Mr. Game & Watch wins.
I'm really curious to see where he will go in this bracket. As I said, like I played him for the first time last Tuesday, and he was a very good player, I have to say. I think he can be that upset factor that I was talking about before, going a little bit further in bracket than maybe predicted.
battle. Mr. Game and Watch.
All right. Game two. Krispy coming tricks to Hollow Bastion. A little bit bigger of a stage, more room for him to work with. Maybe he can get that little bit more distance and start using those PK fires, those ranged tools that Ness has to just get that Game & Watch out of here. A lot of grabs here. But Infinite gets that one little hit and he starts converting it into 38 damage. That's some good conversions. So now he's going to try to get his way off stage through the infamous PK fires. Oof, that was a great roll read there. Krispy throwing him off stage, asking, what are you doing with that unsafe nair? I can challenge that. Suddenly, this is a very even game. Ness obviously has that kill power. He can kill with so many options. Forward smash being one of them, we just saw it. But how much extra credit can you do? Wow, these PK fires 51%. That is a lot of damage to be getting on this second stock, making Infinite a little bit desperate to get this first stock out of the way so he can start getting back into this game. There you go, that is what he needed. Evening up the stock counts, now he just needs a nair, an upbeat, something through his combo starters, start racking up this damage with the up airs, as we see. Just, wow. So much damage in such a short period of time. One advantage day win, and he gets 72, 84% off of it, 90, now he's off stage. This just might be a kill. He hasn't landed yet. He's still trying to get back. Oh wow, that down smash barely whipping. Krispy sort of weaving his way back onto the stage. Now that down smash, gonna be taking the second stock. Krispy suddenly looking much better the second game. Maybe the counter pick was working, maybe he had a little bit of adaption coming in. But Infinite saying absolutely not. I want to end this 2-0 and just end this set. Doing a little cheapy stuff there at the ledge. Now they're just boxing. Nair into the up air. Just misses it. But it's a good idea. Of course, Krispy fighting. This could potentially be his last stop in winner's side bracket. He needs to do something here. Get away, but Infinite catching these rolls in with the down smash, such a good option for covering so much space around him. Starting to get really scary. They are both at kill percent, but the down smash will take it. Infinite will win 2-0.
Mr. Game & Watch wins!